Have you ever looked at the Wikipedia page of a dwarf planet and thought, man, I wish I knew this much about my fictional dwarf planet. Why am I even asking? Of course you have, let's do this. YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. The most important variables to consider when building any planet, dwarf or not, are radius, mass, surface gravity, and density. To know these physical parameters is to know one's planet. Luckily, one very simple yet extremely important world-building equation governs all four values. Gravity is equal to mass over the radius squared, which is equal to the radius times the density. By the way, all values in this video, unless otherwise stated, are relative to the Earth being equal to 1. Now, before we go throwing numbers at this equation, let's talk ranges for a second. The mass range for dwarf planets is 0.0001 to 0.1 Earth masses, and their radii should be greater than 0.03 Earth radii. The values for density and surface gravity are more flexible, and we can let the equation determine them. Additionally, these ranges are not fixed. Think of them more as guidelines, so feel free to fudge the details either way if you need to. Just don't go crazy. Got it? Cool, let's build. Here's my little dwarf planet, Peter. Let's give him a mass of 0.0002 Earth masses and a radius of 0.084. After a bit of number crunching, Peter turns out to have a surface gravity 0.028 times that of Earth's, and a density of 0.3. And this is great! But what does it all mean? They're just figures, right? Well, not really. The figures help tell the story of our dwarf planet. Peter's low mass indicates he is barely massive enough to be in hydrostatic equilibrium, and his low density indicates that he's primarily composed of ices. His radius is only 8.4% that of Earth's, and his surface gravity, 3%. So in essence, what we've created here is a tiny ice world that lives on the edge, blurring the lines between dwarf planet and small solar system body. So here is the Earth and the Moon. And here's Peter shown to scale. Look at him, he's so tiny and cute. Anyways, let's calculate some additional parameters. Escape velocity, perhaps. Escape velocity is the minimum speed an object has to travel to escape a planet's gravitational pull without further propulsion. Escape velocity is given by the square root of the mass divided by the radius. Again, remember, your answers here will be relative to the Earth's escape velocity being equal to 1. Some more number crunching and we get a value of 0.05, which we can then multiply by the absolute value of the escape velocity at Earth, and boom! Turns out to escape Peter's gravitational pull, we need to be traveling at 0.56 kilometers per second. So I think now is a good time to take all our previous values and multiply them by their respective values on Earth, which will give us a nice set of absolute values. From here, we can take the absolute value of our planet's radius and use the basic geometry we all learnt in school and haven't forgotten to figure out Peter's circumference, surface area, and volume. In this case, 2 pi times a radius gives us a circumference of about 3,300 kilometers. 4 pi times the radius squared gives us a surface area of about 3.5 million square kilometers. And finally, 4 over 3 pi times the radius cubed gives us a volume of just over 600 million cubic kilometers. But Peter's feeling kinda lonely. Let's give him a companion, because we care deeply about him, and also because we want to try out different variables and see what the consequences are. Same equations and ranges as before. Let's go with something a little more massive, say 0.013 Earth masses. Similarly, let's choose a higher density of, say, 0.5. One intense abacus session later and we see that Petra is a dwarf planet with the following stats, with values relative to Earth being here and absolute values being there. Again, the story these figures tell is of a radically different dwarf planet. Petra is a bit of a bruiser, roughly as large and as massive as Jupiter's moon Io, and as dense as Eris. A true heavyweight rocky dwarf planet. Once more, here's Earth, here's the Moon, and here's Peter and Petra. I think they make quite the couple of cosmic cue balls, proof that opposites attract, eh? And in part, the difference is in the densities. A low density world will be composed of ices, intermediate density dwarf planets will be composed of a mixture of ice and rock, and high densities will indicate a predominantly rocky composition. Unfortunately, it's difficult to give a nice neat set of values on the density ranges for dwarf planets. I would advocate that when you finish building your planet, always cross-reference your results with the stats in this Wikipedia page. Links in the doobly-doo, just so we know exactly what we're dealing with. With that in mind, go forth and build, and let me know what stories your figures tell down in the comments. Guys, if you like what you see here in Artifexian, click the links in the description to find me on Facebook and Twitter. And if you're interested, hit like and subscribe for more awesome science-based world building. Thank you all so much for watching. Edgar out.